you have to describe a migration in fishes, and also you have to discuss the what are the significance of migration in fishes. Clear? Yes, hello, hi everyone. Hope all you are doing so well. So today we are going to discuss a PYQ, okay, which come in year 2021. Okay, so what was the question? The question was, you have to describe a migration in fishes, and also you have to discuss the what are the significance of migration in fishes. Clear? This topic is from your core data, okay? As you know that your first unit is quite important, in which you have non-chordates and chordate, okay? This PYQ came from the topic of core data. Clear? So now we are going to talk about what is migration. So in general term, you all know that what is migration? Migration means when an organism moves from one place to the another place, that is your migration. Clear? Suppose if you have any population here, clear? If in this population people came, okay, then this is known as immigration. Clear? And from this population people goes out, that is known as emigration. Okay, that is a simple definition of a migration. So migration is what? Is the movement of large number of animals, see, from one place to where? From the another. And migration have a different purpose. Organism or any animals, why they do migrate? Because for the purpose of feeding, for the purpose of spawning, for the purpose of reproduction and the other extreme weather. Might be now the climatic condition is not good for organism. So definitely for their survival, they have to migrate from one position to the another. Suppose if there is no food in any place, so what organism do? Definitely for their survival, they are going to move from one position to the another. Clear? So migratory behavior of fish, it is a regular phenomenon. Clear? So migration is shown by fishes for their feeding purpose, for their spawning purpose, or might be a reason of a climatic. Clear? Now we are going to talk about the type of fishes migration on the basis of their needs. Okay, what is the requirement that fishes have to do migration? Clear? So the first is feeding migration. Feeding means khane se related hai kuch yahan. Okay, feeding migration is also known as alimentary migration. It is also known as what? It is also known as alimentary migration. Okay, so here migration for searching of food. Clear? Now spawning migration. Spawning migration is also known as gametic migration. Okay, it is also known as gametic migration. Spawning का मतलब क्या होता है? What is spawning means? Means egg laying. Okay, for the production of egg laying, they have to move from their place. Clear? So it occurs during the breeding season in search for the suitable spawning ground where they do spawning. Clear? Now it is a climatic condition or the climatic migration. Climatic migration, also known as seasonal migration. For example, they are not able to survive in spring season, or some of the fishes are not able to survive in autumn season, so they migrate from one position to the another place. Simple. Okay, so migration in search for the suitable climatic condition. Now it is a juvenile migration. It is a larval migration. Basically larval migration from spawning ground to the feeding habitat of their parent, because parent moves to the spawning ground for the spawning purpose. So once the egg is going to be hatched, and now larva will become an adult, so for their feeding purpose again they move to their parent place. Yes or no? For their feeding purpose. So that is known as juvenile migration. Clear? Now, type of fish is migration against according to where they migrate. Where they migrate actually from freshwater to seawater or seawater to freshwater. Okay. This migration, it's depend on the needs. Okay. अब हम नेक्स्ट देखेंगे कि माइग्रेशन कहाँ से कहाँ तक होता है. फ्रेश से सी वाटर से हो रहा है या सी वाटर से फ्रेश वाटर हो रहा है. ओके, इन दिस वी ऑल्सो हैव वन अनदर टाइप ऑफ अ माइग्रेशन दैट इज नोन एज ऑस्मो रेगुलेटरी माइग्रेशन. दैट इज नोन एज ऑस्मो रेगुलेटरी माइग्रेशन. सो वॉट हैपन इन दिस टाइप ऑफ अ माइग्रेशन, हेयर फिशेज मूव फ्रॉम fresh water to sea water, fresh water to sea, okay, and some fishes moves from sea to fresh, vice versa, okay. Why? See, osmo means for maintaining their osmotic balance, to maintain a level of salts and the ions in their body, they have to move from fresh to salt or fresh to sea water, or some moves from sea to फ्रेश वाटर. आप वाइस वर्सा करके भी बोल सकते हैं. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट, सो द टाइप ऑफ माइग्रेशन, द फर्स्ट वी हैव लेटिट्यूडिनल माइग्रेशन. सो व्हाट हैपन इन दिस माइग्रेशन, इट इज़ अ माइग्रेशन ऑफ फिश फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ एंड द वाइस वर्सा बिकॉज ऑफ द क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन. ओके, इन नॉर्थ व्हेन दे मूव इन नॉर्थ व्हेन देयर इज अ स्प्रिंग कंडीशन. ओके, which condition is it? Spring condition. And when they move to the south, when there is a autumn like condition. Clear? Which fishes show this latitudinal migration? Swordfish and the barracudas. Clear? Next we have vertical migration. In vertical migration, it is a daily migration of fish from the deep surface and the vice versa for food or the protection etc. Okay, why they migrate? For their feeding purpose. Okay, and for their protection, might be they have a danger with some other species, that's why for their protection they move from another place. Yes, so this type of a migration is known as vertical migration, and the example is swordfish. Clear. Next we have potamudras migration. What is potamudras migration? It is a freshwater migration of a fish from one habitat to the another. Okay, this migration is going on where? Freshwater. Okay, and why this migration is happening? For again feeding purpose, for their food requirement and for the spawning. क्योंकि जहाँ वो रह रहे हैं हो सकता है वो कंडीशन उनके लिए सुइटेबल नहीं है फॉर स्पॉनिंग पर्पज, दैट्स वाई दे मूव. क्लियर. एंड इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज द लिमोड्रोनस माइग्रेशन. ओके, इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज द लिमोड्रोमस माइग्रेशन. एग्जाम्पल इज कार्प्स एंड द कैटफिश. क्लियर. नेक्स्ट वी हैव ओशियन ड्रोमस माइग्रेशन. वॉट इज ओशियन ड्रोमस माइग्रेशन? इट इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ अ माइग्रेशन ऑफ फ्रेश of a fish within the sea only, means in sea water they migrate. सी के अंदर ही ये migrate कर रही है. हो सकता है सी में एक particular place है, वहाँ से एक जगह से ये दूसरी जगह जा रही है. यहाँ ऐसा नहीं है सी से fresh water जा रहा है या fresh से sea water जा रहा है. That's not like that happen. Okay, within the sea they migrate. Okay, so this type of a migration is known as oceanodromous migration. Why they migrate? Again for feeding and spawning ground purpose. Example is tuna and crupia. Next we have diadromous migration. And diadromous migration, it is a true type of migration because here fishes move from fresh water to sea, or some moves from sea to fresh water for their spawning purpose. Clear? It is a migration of fish between the fresh water and marine water. Some fishes regularly migrate from sea again, sea and fresh water. For the very first time, this diadromous migration was noticed by scientist George S. Mayer in which year? In 1949. This is important. Next, as I told you, they are true migratory fishes. And diadromous migration is of three types. The first is the anadromous migration, where fishes move from seawater to fish water. Clear? Anadromous means sea water to fresh water. See, it is the migration of marine fishes from sea to the fresh water. For which purpose? For spawning purpose. Clear? Fishes spend most of their life in sea, but when they have to migrate, when they have to be bred, and when there's a breeding season came in the fishes, so they migrate into the fresh water for the suitable spawning ground. Clear? To the river for spawning ground. See, example is your salmon, hilsa, and your sturgeon, etc. The next is catadromous migration. This is a migration of freshwater fishes from the sea. Again, for when it is happened during the breeding season for spawning purpose. Example is freshwater eel, and the scientific name is Anguilla. Clear? Next we have amphidromous migration. Amphidromous migration fishes from freshwater to marine and marine water to again fresh. For example, here we have a fish which lives in a fresh water. So fresh water to where it they move? They moves in the marine water. Clear? And again, they moves from marine water to the fresh water. So they have a dual type of migration. Because amphibian, amphibian means ये होता है dual. ये दोनों जगह migration कर सकती हैं. Fresh से marine में भी और marine से fresh में भी. Amphi stands for the dual. Clear? Next, without the purpose of breeding, they don't have a purpose like this कि इन्हें breeding करना है. That's why they move there. No. But ये किसके लिए move करती हैं? They move for feeding purpose, for the shelter, etc. Next example we have Megalopa and Canoids, etc. Clear? Next we are going to talk about the eels. Okay, we here talk about eels show which type of migration. So eel is the best example of catadromous migration. Clear? Eels show the best type of a catadromous migration. So here two most common species we have of eels which showing this catadromous migration. Example is Anguilla vulgaris, which is also known as European eels. The next we have Anguilla rostrata, which is an American eel. Clear? So in eels we have two species, the Anguilla vulgaris and the another one Anguilla rostrata. Clear? Now we talk about when they migrate. So during the autumn season, when? During the autumn, their color changes from yellow to the metallic silver. Because of the change in environment, their color is going to be changed. Which color they are going to be changed? From yellow to the metallic silver. And their feeding is stopped because of the climatic change and with the shrinking of their digestive tract. Now their eyes become larger and the snout, the mouth part becomes a sharper and the gonads are fully mature, because in that particular time they are ready to breed. Clear? The silver eels then enters into the sea and migrate about 4,500 kilometers for reaching their breeding place. Clear? After that, adult die after spawning into the deep waters. Once they do spawning, the adult one is going to be died. Clear? The eggs hatch into the little transparent leaf like flattened pelagic larva. Transparent means their body is transparent. Okay, aap aar paar dekh sakte ho. Flattened pelagic larva that called as a leptocephalia. Okay, that is known as the leptocephalia. Their length is about 6 mm long. Okay, and they have a sharp needle like teeth for what? For the feeding. Because they have to be feed na. So definitely they have a piercing type of a mouth. And they grow into the alvers, or the, you can say that the glass eels. Because they are look like a transparent in nature, so we say that the glass eels. They are about 8 cm long with having cylindrical body. The alver feeds and grow into the yellow eels like their parent in some years. Clear? So you can see here the leptocephalia and the glass eels. And this is what? This is a adult eel. Yes, you can see their body is completely transparent. The next, here they are showing the migration, clear? So see, once a fully adult eel forms, they again enters where? They again enters into the, see where it is going? It is going into the fresh water, clear? Now we have another one, the salmon. Salmon show the anadromous type of migration. So this is a single species of Atlantic salmon. Okay, what is it? Atlantic salmon. Their genus is Salmon salal. And the five species of Pacific salmon and the genus is Oncorhynchus. Okay, genus is what? Oncorhynchus. They are the best example of the anadromous migration. So when they do migrate in winter, both the sexes leave their feeding ground, both male and the female, both leave their feeding ground and reaches to the fresh water, because from where they are going to go in fresh water, clear? Streams, they stop feeding, change to the dull reddish brown from silver. Same unke jaisa hoga, inka bhi color change hoga, feeding rok denge and ready to breed, clear? And make a hole in bottom gravel. What they do before spawning, they clears all the stones from the bottom of a sea. Sare wahan se stones, pebbles hatayenge, ek gravel, ek gadda banayenge, jahan par ye egg ko lay kar sake, clear? After spawning, the adult die, but not all the adults die. Some of the adults again going where? They again return to the sea water. Clear? For spawn, for the second time in life, after hatching, the larval fish feed and grow very young salmons and are known as alevians. Clear? Alevians develop into the next stage, that is called as par, and final to what? Final to the adult. Clear? Now the young salmons grow faster in the ocean because of what? Because there's a lots of food there. Clear? So this is clear to you? Now see, this is the representation of your salmon life cycle. You can see here a par. Yes, you can see here the fry. You can see here the alevin. Egg hatch into the alevin. Alevin become fry. Fry become par. Par becomes smolt, smolt become the adult salmon, clear? Here this is representing their freshwater phase and the dark blue color is representing their seawater phase, okay? So this is what? This is their freshwater phase, clear? Now, what is the significance of fish migration? What are the benefit of this? First, to find suitable feeding. क्योंकि अपने सर्वाइव के लिए इनको भी खाना पड़ेगा ओके बिकॉज वॉट एवर द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म वी हैव इन दिस प्लैनेट दे ऑल रिक्वायर फूड फॉर देयर मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटीज फॉर देयर सेलुलर एक्टिविटीज क्लियर सो टू फाइंड सुटेबल फीडिंग एंड स्पॉनिंग ग्राउंड फॉर प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम द प्रेडेटर्स क्लियर देखा था ना अभी जो फिशेस को डर था वो क्या करती है एम्फीड्रोमस माइग्रेशन क्यों शो करती है to protect from the predators, survive from extreme climate conditions, increase their genetic diversities, and it is an adaptation character for survival and the existence, clear? So these all are the benefits of migration in fishes, clear? Thank you so much. Next time we will going to discuss with another topic.